Le Meilleur d'entre nous is a novel about why we bake, but it's not really just about that. It's about our relationship with food, and it's about motherhood, really. I suppose above all, it's about the process or about of being a woman these days, about our roles and our needs and how we try and reconcile the two. It's about the pressures that we put on ourselves. It's about the difference between appearance and reality, and it's about the impossibility of perfection. It's about a baking competition that's inspired by a vintage 1960s cookery book called The Art of Baking, or L'Art de la Pâtisserie. And this was written by a woman called Kathleen Eden in the 1960s. And in it, she purports to describe the best way in which to make the most exquisite tarts and cakes and bread. And the implication is that if you manage to do this, you're going to be the perfect wife and mother, and you're going to have this wonderfully happy family. And as the competition progresses, each of the five contestants, four women and a man, we see their lives unravel. And we see that really their lives aren't that perfect at all. And of course, by the end of the competition, we realise that Kathleen Eden's life was a bit of a fiction as well. Her perfect life was a bit of a fiction. So the idea of Le Meilleur d'entre nous, or The Art of Baking Blind as it is in English, came to me as I was baking with my children. I used to be a journalist. I was a political correspondent on a broadsheet newspaper called The Guardian. And I gave up my job after having my second child. And I found that quite hard to adapt to. And I was spending all this time in the kitchen trying to make the most perfect cakes with them, and biscuits and bread. I was roasting chickens, I was making risottos. And I wondered why I was investing so much emotion into this food. And I realized that I was trying to sort of convince myself that if I cooked them the most exquisite food, then I was somehow proving that I was a good mother. You know, I was proving it to myself, really. And about the same time, the baking bug really took off in Britain, and there's a program called The Great British Bake Off. I think you have Lumiere Petitier, and it's a competition about cakes. And I caught the very end of the 2011 series, and the woman who eventually won it said she baked because she just wanted to do something for herself. A couple of weeks later, it emerged that her husband was in prison for his part in a £60 million fraud. And I thought, my God, she's got a reason to bake. And then I just thought, well, why else would you put yourself through a competition like that? And as a journalist, I'd always been really fascinated in people's backstories, you know, the reasons we are all as we are, and we have our foibles. And as I was baking with my children, I just kept thinking about the sort of women I see at the school gate who make cakes, you know, and the intense competition in the cake sales at school that my daughter was going to. And three other characters really just formed in my head as I was making these cakes for my children. And then the idea of Kathleen Eden and this wonderful cake book, and I just sort of wrote it from there. For 15 years I was a news reporter, and I did news stories, I did health stories, and then I did politics. And it was only once I'd stopped creating in that way that I then started creating fiction. I was able to write fiction. But it was really interesting that when I was freelancing, but I was frustrated in what I was writing, and I was doing all this cooking, you know, all this creativity with my kids. And as I wrote the book, obviously I continued to bake because I wanted to teach myself how to make the things I was writing about. But as I got more and more into the book, I didn't want to be making the cakes as much. I just wanted to put all my creative energy into the, and there's definitely a parallel. You know, I've created something that I hope is appetizing and delicious, but that has a slightly tart edge to it as well. You know, and I hope you all enjoy tasting it.